Hello there, little Miss Tricky. Happy Sunday. Mija stole an almond. But she's getting to that age where she can try and get them open. Most of the time, she just stashes them. Hey, Karen.
Yep. She's got herself an almond, and she's going to protect it at all costs. We've been fighting over some of the things that she has been running off with lately, and boy, she gets vocal. She gets all grr and chirpy and barky. Yeah, she doesn't want to share this with anybody. She's got a big stash of sticks and things around here. She's doing pretty well dragging them up the cat tree or into this cat tree or the tree. Alright, I won't get in your face. She's almost there. It's like they work a seam around the edge if it's too big. They crack that first, and then they work their way most of the time from the pointy end. Hey, Sashuda. This is Mija. She's about just over 3 months old now. Yeah, I know. Her eye looks really good. I was a little nervous yesterday because it was getting real cloudy. And when that happens, that's usually indicative of a nose injury or a dental issue. Hi, Beverly. So I kept the med on it. I kept it warm and clean all day. I was babysitting her eye more than anything and checked with the vet, and we're on a good course and it looks great today. So I'm really happy about that. I was just a little worried. But now she's beautifully healed in every way. Hey, Heather. Hey, Mike, how you doing? Good Sunday to all of you. She appears to be having the time of her life. She's been bouncing off the walls all morning, hunting and gathering things. She's already restuffed the cat tree. I cleaned this cat tree. Oh, yeah, shake your tail, shake it. I clean this cat tree every morning, along with the floors, before she comes out here. She still sleeps in a little cage with us in the bedroom. She gets real industrious first thing in the morning. She had a great breakfast. She got a lot of formula. You can see that she's blinking that right eye. So I'm sure it's still irritated, but it looks so much better than it has. It was a little more swollen, so that's gone, it appears. Her eyelid is a great shape. Hi, Fiona. Good afternoon to you, probably evening.
Many people watching me that night.
Dad's annoying. Oh, hi.
There's a drive-by fruiting.
She came, bounced off my face, and kept on going.
Thank you. She's definitely touched mine. Every time one of the girls gone Brisby so far, he's been the only boy. But all of them have come through and just made a huge difference in everything. Uniquely, each one too, because we're all at a different phase. So when a new one comes through, it's you're at a different point in your life, and we've just raised, like here, we've just raised Talon and Lazarus and released them.
And that was a really exciting time because we'd never had two at once. We'd never had girls. And it did a lot of healing here as well. And then right on their heels, as I'm adjusting to them being outside and playing with them and watching them grow out there, Mija shows up and sort of starts the cycle again, but we find ourselves at a better place from what we had just experienced. And she's into her almond. Good girl. Now she's gone. Run away. I know. Dad. She's like a teenager now. Don't talk about me to your friends. Hi, Beverly. Tweedlebird is really at it. Spin, spin, spin. Yeah, her eye looks 1,000% better. Still just a little red around the rim, but there's no cloudiness. There's no build up on the edges. Usually when she's been racing around and gets, you know, a little heated, it starts to get lazy and she gets some of that sleep in her eyes. But right now, it looks clear as the other one. Wide open and round, perfect. Hey Shelly, how you doing? Oh, if you want some of those cool socks, you gotta talk to Shelly. In fact, I'm wearing my squirrel socks right now.
I think Tina wore the white pair to work. But she's got much more than squirrels.
Just feel like you're a landing pad between two destinations. Focus. I think I went a little nuts this morning with the postings. I was really behind. I am still downloading video from that period of time where the internet was worse than it is now. And so I'm still downloading those, so I'm finding groups of photos and videos that, you know, as she grew, it was hysterical and beautiful pictures, especially those with the umbrella and the two chairs. In a couple of them, it looks like she's setting up her towel and just ready to enjoy the day. And it's all the way out. Good girl. It's interesting how they hold the shell, even though they really don't need to, and I think... And I watched Brisby do it, and Tina and I spoke about it. That he used it as a plate, almost to make sure that whatever he was holding didn't escape through the bottom. Because even though they have real great dexterity on their hands, they're missing the thumb, and they can grip things, but they tend to lose things a lot of times through the bottom. And so yesterday I was watching her, she got into a hazelnut, and... Yeah, like a bowl, Karen says. She got into a hazelnut, dropped the shell, started eating the inside, and then reached out for the bowl part of it, the shell again, and picked it back up and then continued eating. And Brisby would do that with pumpkin seeds. Hang tight. This dude's been working on his car for... I think he's getting to the tuning phase of it. What is that? Woodpecker? Sorry if I lose my shot. I know that looks terrible.
visitor.
I don't mean to alarm anyone, but it appears we're being followed.
You gonna stash the shell for later?
No.
We're looking for leftovers.
Hey, Harry.
Next weekend, we're going up to see Harry. Pick him up and bring him down here for a couple days.
And we're going to go to that squirrel summit out in Orange City.
Yeah, she's got a beautiful red on her sides. But next weekend is that squirrel summit at Blue Springs, I believe the name of it is. It's in Orange City, Florida. And many people are making it from all over the world. Coming and staying in cabins and hotels, and there are events. Sunday, I believe, is the 7th, is when the actual events happen. Now, I'm saying events because I have no idea what to expect in any way, shape, or form. So, but it's about squirrels, so it can't be bad. Right?
Yes, I know.
Daddy's being silly today and not wearing the jacket. He's gonna look like he got into a fight with a weed eater.
What are you doing?
You wanna play or you wanna rub? Make up my mind. Which is it? I'm seeing a buildup of speed, so. Thinking that she is. Yep.
There was no way to catch up with that.
Ooh, nice hang. This is Tater.
So, because you remind me of a baked potato.
Oh, honey.
Don't you wish you had energy like that for just one day?
Oh, man, I really need one of those gimbal things.
It's got like a gyroscope on it. Shelly was telling me, she showed me. It's, sort of a gyroscope for your phone so that you hold the handle and regardless of what angle you're at, it will hold the orientation the right way. And I'd like to try and find one for
Whoa.
That scared everybody. This is why we play over the mats. And a big structure with a lot of room to grab, just like in the trees, because she's gonna need to figure out how, if she falls out of a branch, it breaks. They break here all the time. I mean, just look at my yard. How to scrabble and free fall and reach out. If you've seen the movie Avatar, it's sort of that idea. Of her teaching Jake how to fall out of the trees without apparently damaging anyone, including himself. Scary girl. She had full formula this morning, so it's no wonder she is wired for sound today.
Yeah.
You can feel it coming up. Just 1,000 miles an hour. Here we go. I'll tell you, you saw about as much of that as I did. Hey. Thank you. Sometimes I feel like she wonders why I'm not following at warp 10. Hey, Liz. Like she. Oh, if you're not a sci-fi or fantasy or horror geek or, you know, that type of entertainment, you may not get a lot of my references. Because that's where they all come from. Sometimes it's just by a claw. Who plugged you in last night? Left you on the charger for too long. It's good that she's getting this workout. As scary as it is sometimes to watch. Because sometimes in the trees, whether it's from predator or another squirrel, or just cause they feel like having at it in roughhousing, there are no mats out there. She needs to be as accurate as she can and as strong as she can doing all of this. So, the method to the madness, or the madness to the method, is... Hey, John. What's happening? Mija, the mad here. The mad queen. I was just saying that this will, encouraging all of these behaviors, will let her be more agile in the trees. She's not getting this training from her mom. Her siblings. And Lazarus and Talon had each other to sort of urge one another on. And Brisby was an experiment in experiments. And we had no idea what was happening. Thank you.
with each one we learn.
Be one of the things that I'll add onto my wish list is a some of those elementary school mats, these little puzzle things, and that way I can do the whole area back here where they all play. This has basically become their half of the porch. Not that they care about it being half, they do the whole thing, but their stuff is on this side.
Behold my stuff.
I have new grooves in my thumb. And definitely in my hat. Claw to the eyeball. Take two. Saw a post the other day, one of the times that she was making a nest on my head. And I realized that my forehead looked like I'd gotten in a fight with a stapler. And that is all little Miss Thing here. All those little dings and dents and, I mean, if it's in a scar, the one over my eye has been there since I was 5, so. But the new ones. Hey, excuse me. Can I interest you in food? Or playing? Not chewing on my hat? No thanks, I'll continue. I'm really into this. And single-mindedness has never been defined until you've been around a squirrel. And like any child, they know what you don't want them to do, and that's their focus. Sweet.
She's eating a Henry's block.
That's not always as easy as it sounds. Like when they transition from formula, they should go right into Henry's blocks. But it's not like you drop it off at them and say, okay, here. And they pick it up and go, oh, this is delicious. And they happily ever after. It's not automatic. You have to encourage it, but you have to make sure that you're not giving them anything else that they would prefer. Like nuts, until they've established a good eating habit with these blocks. And then they start to realize that their nutrients and everything that their body's craving is within that at an early age. And so even when they start to get nuts and other sweets or vegetables and fruits and things introduced into their diet, their body will crave this as the source of its needs. No, there's a little trick to it, and Jill Horstman taught me that at the end of Brisby, because he got the experimental treatment. We gave him everything under the sun to eat that we reasonably thought baby squirrel would be able to handle. It wasn't awful, but it wasn't the preferred diet.
Did I refer to a story?
Something that I probably shouldn't tell.
Oh, sorry. This is my shot trying to pull a shell out of my shoe. Look at that spin. Hey, Brooke. Good morning. Well, I suppose it's noonish here, right? I don't know.
part of the thing in transitioning to all this digital is that there aren't wall clocks. I mean, we don't even have them. Not that we spend any time
within the walls.
You clicking it.
Stretch.
The one time I don't wear my hoodie. And it seems like she may want to take a nap. Oh, there are no end to the shells in my boots. I sound like a rattlesnake when I walk and a rain stick when I start to take my armor off. Smells like smoke out here. One of the neighbors is burning all the stuff that falls. To the door. You were looking for that nut that I just probably took out of my shoe. It's only the shell, sweetie. Yeah, she's winding down now. Not to say that. I was just getting ready to say, not to say that any second that could change. They don't need a lot of recharge time. Right? So yeah, good 2 seconds and I'm ready to go. As you were saying. I caught a shot of her, and I think I posted it somewhere, no idea where, of her in free fall off one of the screens. And that's just how they descend so fast, or one of the ways they descend so fast, is they don't grab every branch or everything that's in their way. They'll just sort of hang out close to the tree or the branch or the joey and just drag their nails lightly against it in case they need to grip or change direction. It's the coolest and scariest thing. Until you figure out what they're doing, I was a little nervous that they were missing. They weren't getting enough training in the trees by not having them here. So that's when I got that big old, come on, flip. That's when I got that big old branch for behind the cat tree, which has been great, except, you know, the leaves are not in good shape. Oh, she's got to go potty. Anybody seen a squirrel? Oh, there's one. Dad, you're out of soda. Mom's horn, but it's too early. Something caught her nose. She's on the hunt. I think she found, no? No, that wasn't it. Oh, hi. Thank you. Well, am I holding it? Imagine that.
just like that.
Thanks, sweetie.
See ya.
Steal now.
A thief, a thief, a thief.
Every bit.
You don't want her running off with it?
Nail it down.
Put it away.
Take my hands, hey girl.
Yeah.
Get that stinger tail up. Make it bigger. Good girl. Come here, Letitia. No, she's not going to be outside anytime soon. She is going to have her first solo day, though, coming up pretty soon. That's going to be.
She's gonna have to spend time on her own in here, but
Daddy's not prepared. European.
Oops. Oh yeah. Sorry.
She's run off to the walnut. I can handle that.
It's this mess over here I don't want her in.
Hi. Me? Nothing. Just cleaning up your potty.
Me?
Hey, I dropped nut. Right there. She's tapping her tail against me as we walk. Dan, stay still. Hey, Patty. Mija's practicing my balancing act. Yeah, it's a neat little stand, my hat, because it catches food as it drops, so they don't have to go so far down. I have no idea if she's in this shot. I can't see. I wonder if I can see me on my computer. Or will I create a feedback loop and now we need to go back in time? Yeah, that's sort of trippy. Sort of helps me. I'm watching it on TV. I wonder. I'm pushing my luck here.
Your mess?
I didn't think so. That's my job, right?
She's definitely learned that usually there are things in my pockets worth discovering. Oh, if you see anything raining down in the shot, it's whatever she just ate on my head.
Come on. Ta-da. Yeah, I think that there's a lot of leftovers up there, shredded. Can we go back over here now? And can I walk forward? I hope that doesn't fall.
Wow. That was quite the adventure. Better now?
Yeah, that's what I thought.
Still corn raining down.
Thanks for hanging out.
I appreciate you spending your Sunday with me.
And Mija.
Oh. You know, I think when I put up this gate, the only obstacle that it presents is to me. Yeah, there's no winding down here. There are just brief pauses between insanity. She found something good over here once. She's gonna keep trying and trying and trying. So I try and put things on the other side that are just as intriguing to her in hopes that she'll maybe think that side's better. But whatever side you don't want them to be on, that's where they're headed. Not a real tree, sweetie. Unfortunately, all four of them have tried to jump up that tree at least once.
Why must you chew on the hat? Patty got you those awesome bamboo chews that you make into splinters in no time. Let's do that. Yeah, we can do that. I'll just snack while you rub me. I see a tail relaxing. Hey, Galina. Far away, it must always look like I have something on my mind and I'm just rubbing my head to the neighbors that walk by.
Guy's always scratching his head. It cracks me up when she sits back like that on her butt. Oh, I'm glad you're enjoying your meal up there. I take my hat off, will you chew on my head? I don't recall who made this hat. I recall where we got it. It is no longer a place you can go to get it, but I will attest to its durability. They made a heck of a hat.
Hey, Karen. One day I'll look up who made the hat and write them a big thank you, and you make a heck of a hat.
You're on the hunt.
Yup.
Yeah, you can chew on those. Those things have seen much better days.
And they're made of the same thing. They're made out of splinters and pain.
Gonna say she must have something she knows I didn't want her to have, because she's going downfield
and trying to get as far away from me. I got this thing all screwed up.
Okay, she's trying to get as far away from me as she can because she had a hazelnut. Come here, sweetie, I'll get it for you.
One of us could go get it, but not both of us. All right. Yes, you're watching me pick up nuts. I didn't have enough mental faculty to get everything on the right page at the right time.
Yeah.
Here. No, not my finger.
Spin it. Good girl.
Yeah, you stay there. There were two in the area yesterday. It took up a lot of time. You stay by me. Yeah. We're holding hands. Yes, you stay here. This ought to take her a while. She got into the one yesterday pretty quick. Sorry. Touch the toe. Wanna go over there? This is her undercover spot.
guarded on three sides with a little lookout. And of course, overhead protection. Yesterday I was the madman out in the yard waving off hawks and shaking shiny things at them. What's the raven saying? The ravens are talking about that hawk, I'm pretty sure. Are videos normally this long on Facebook? I don't know if I'm overstaying my welcome. It's like the channel that won't go away. She's good in here, and she instinctively ran right into the cat tree and into this mess, which is great because her first instinct should be to get to as deep a shelter as she can find. And after that, then hopefully, you know, against a branch or something that she can't be seen if she can't get into somewhere. Yeah, those ravens freaking out back there are actually a good sign for us. Because it sounds like the hawk is either in that area or headed around them. And the farther they are from us, the better off we are. It's very rare that you hear them so close, the hawks. Ravens you hear all the time. Hey, Regina. Got Mija here spinning her hazelnut. She found one in one of her sister's stashes. You can't even say that word properly without putting a little squirrel voice into it. Sisters. This is Mija. She's just over 3 months. Doing really well, still on formula in the mornings. And then the rest of the day, she grazes Henry blocks, and now she's just starting to discover the nuts that her sisters have left behind. Or they still come in stash. Yeah, Harry and I are going to get together next weekend to go to that squirrel event out at Blue Springs in Orange City. I'm going to go pick him up, and then he's going to spend a couple days here with us, and hopefully he'll get to meet Mija, Lazarus, Talon, and get a Brisby sighting in. But I'm looking forward to that event and getting Harry started in his rehab. Oh yeah, she'll get into it. I've never been so familiar with various types of nuts as I have till recently, and there's a little ledge around the top of that nut that she's slowly working her teeth into. Now she's getting at the bottom. Sometimes that's the easiest place to crack them. There's a seam that seems to run down the side. Yesterday she popped it like a top. There must have been a ridge that she could get into, and she jammed her teeth down in there. It was open. This one's a lot more work. Yeah, Harry's going to be really good. He's great with his squirrels. He's gotten so many wild ones to trust him, and he's so happy when he gets to spend time with them. And there's no healing like it, so I'm looking forward to his experience. And of course, we always need more help. Oh, thank you. I appreciate that. still tracking the ravens. Now they're farther west, so either they've harassed that hawk out of the area, or yeah, they're going farther. There's more farmland out in that area, a lot more open sky. Well, don't mess around. Tell us how you feel about that Henry's block. She's done so good. She came in at 5 weeks, a bit of a bloody nose, and an eye injury that came right after that. And yeah, she's looking fantastic. I'm keeping an eye on her eye just to make sure. We've got medication and a vet that advises me. Good job, sweetie. Now she's gonna keep the bowl. That, I think, is, drops it and goes and gets it. That, I think, is something that needs to be looked into. You look happy. Yay. Yeah, this will be your second hazelnut. Spin all the skin off of it before she gets down to business. Or at least an area, I suppose. I enjoy sitting here watching them as much as anyone else. Yeah, next weekend is that squirrel summit. The 6th is really more an arrival day, where people are going to be coming on all day long and finding their lodgings and things. And then that evening, I believe, there's either a meet and greet or some sort of get-together. And then Sunday is when the actual events or get-togethers, I don't know what to expect. I'm very socially, social media challenged, and so apparently there was a lot of information on Instagram that I had no idea where to go find or how to get, and it was all on me, just a lack of knowledge. But I found out enough, so we're going. Thanks for hanging out, Regina. Have a great day. Oh, cool. Grandkids. I need some of those. Right, Mija? We need grandbabies. We got one coming in July, I believe. Little girl. Is that good? Yeah, I bet it was. You're so pretty. I know, it's empty. I like when her ears move. Yeah, chew on it. Get those teeth broken. He's really at that truck. Your noses have to be so sensitive to be able to smell these things, but I think it also helps them determine a lot by the way it's split over their lips. And believe me when I say anything I talk about is pure conjecture. I don't know anything more than anyone else, just through observations. And my own guesswork.
Yes, I know. Daddy makes stuff up all the time. She's definitely eating solid foods, but I'm real glad that she is still on her formula mornings. You look like you're ready to snap the ball. Yeah, they're both empty. Sorry. I know, it's tragic. Out from behind the phone, and she was like, oh, surprise! That spin is insanely fast. Get to twirling some of this stuff, it's just you can't keep track. She just enjoys shredding things. Keeps her teeth down, makes her inclination to chew. Gives her something to work on. Bless you. I could see that sneeze coming. She was doing little jumps. And the first couple times I saw her do that, I was worried it might be something. But then she sneezed. Sorry, sweetie, that's just Dad's old bones cracking and creaking down here enough that she's looking over going, what broke? Enjoy your day, Patty, thanks. Cool show the other night. I need to go to some shows once they get a break in the action. It's been a while since I've seen a decent concert. It's been a while since I've seen any concert, much less a decent one. But that Motley Crue biopic that's on Netflix? Yeah, it's on Netflix right now. It brought back a lot of memories of several shows that we've been to. See him several times throughout high school and right after, and then while we were in Europe, I got to continue seeing them at some epic shows. Your nose is dirty. Yeah, that movie was more nostalgic for me than it was the actual movie, content of the movie. It was more of a way for me to keep track of all those things that I had heard or had been, you know, enthused about as they were happening. Hey, Diane. Uh-oh. I don't know, you're gonna have to go hunt down something else if you want to find Sister Stash. I'm not giving up. I won't give up the location. Yeah, you know I would if she asked. But then if she asked, we would have a whole other different type of video. My luck, it would be a Michigan J. Frog situation. She would only speak to me.
and in front of no one else. Stashes? Yes, you. Yeah, you know we're talking about you. Pay no attention to that squirrel in the tower. I think it's nap time. Or are you still looking? Shake this towel out and duck. All the flying shrapnel that'll come off of it. My fucking.
Feel little sparks of energy. I think those nuts really
timed out well.
If she starts getting energetic again, she's gonna be ready to go. Run.
What you looking for now?
Well, you're enjoying your meals today. Oh. What did Tater do?
Tater hath offended.
Hi, Alicia.
Eat that too. Yeah, it's like I was saying yesterday. She's picking about there. Smelling for the parts that she likes. And I've seen all four of them do that with the Henry's blocks. It's like there'll be a piece of nut or a piece of something that they prefer in one area. So they spin. And then they'll just start dissecting it and say, you know, if there's a piece of this here, I want this little bit of almond or I want this little bit of hazelnut. Because it's composed of all kinds of really good stuff that they like and is good for them. Supposed to be a complete dietary supplement or dietary, you know, substance for their days. So they eat one or two of them, they should be good to go, and the rest is just snacking and getting energy food. Bless you. She's just 3 months and a week now. We got her when she was 5 weeks. And had no tail and no claws. But her eyes were open and took right to the formula. And I'm just really glad she still takes formula in the mornings. I'm surprised because Talon and Lazarus dumped out just before 3 months. No more formula. And Brisby at about 10 weeks. So she's doing great.
stuff in your whiskers, on your arms, your feet, on my hat. You're having a good day, aren't you? Kids are always having their best day when there's stuff all over their face. It means they enjoyed whatever just happened. She was gonna club me with that thing. It's gone. That's usually how it works. Brisby will come in with dirt caked up his nose like he had been mud diving or something. 10 minutes later, he'll come through the door and clean as a whistle. Just dragged it against something as he was eating or running. Man, the voice is really weak. That's a piece of antler. That's the tip of an antler. I took a jigsaw and cut up a rack that I have in the garage. She hasn't really focused too much on gnawing on that piece. But there's a bone handle around here somewhere that she is... There it is. That she's really enjoying. Shoes. Whatever's in that Spanish moss, I'm sure it's the roots. Got it. Get it all. I think you took the rest of it and stuffed it in your nest. That's the next thing that I really want to be looking for, is her to start exhibiting some massive nesting behaviors where she's going to build her own little dray, and more than just dragging paper towels and things into the cat tree. You know, watching her to start weaving things and using branches and... Oh! Yeah, hey! Yeah, I know. Sometimes those trees get stuck. You should go drink some water. This is that bone handle, untreated, but it had never made it to the knife stage, and so it started out like that, and this is what she's done. She'll make bowls, spoons, gnawed by squirrel spoons. Now you got junk all over your face. What you looking for, babe? Wanna play? Time for tater. Boy, you chucked that Henry's block far enough. Busted. It's a large piece of bark that came off one of the trees that I brought in. Yeah. What was that? They're like little tiger sharks. They'll eat anything. Disposals. I think a branch popped on the fire next door. Right? Look at that soft belly. Maybe not happy. Yes, I know that baby's upset. I had to put this butcher's block here because the little pieces of wood that we're holding over the hole were getting worked on.
not going anywhere. I was just getting out of your way. Your new napping spot. Be careful when you spin in there, sweetie, you can bonk your head. Oh, I was gonna leave a bun bun for you, but he's really far. Hold on. Yes, I am going to get my squirrel's stuffed rabbit. I don't want to hear it. Yeah, give Bun Bun kisses. It's about time you share that carrot, Bun Bun. Give it up. You've been holding out on me for weeks. Giving her a good grooming. She sleeps with Bun Bun every night, and when I put her in the crib, put her in the cage with Mija, she reaches out and drags her in, and half the time I find it half in and half out of the igloo that's in there sometimes, like she was trying to drag her all the way into bed. But I've since taken out that igloo, there's just not a lot of room in there with her size now. Headed in to put her toys away. Yeah, if you're gonna play with Bun Bun, you gotta put your toys away. Some things she's terribly destructive, and some things she's pretty careful with. Like that tag on the from Bun Bun's behind. She messes with it and she'll pull at it and all kinds of other stuff, but. As far as gnawing it off or tearing the plastic off of this or that, she's not too bad. Batty still has both eyes and his nose. Why are you chewing on my shoe? Do you want what's under it or do you want the shoe? Good idea. Yeah, me too. But that is a real good idea. Only problem is that she's going to tear that thing apart in a second. So I have been trying to figure out a cap. I don't think I have anything that can grind that down. But I think a screw cap would probably work. I just need to find it. But if it's anything plastic or vinyl or anything like that, she'll chew it to shreds. I think what I might actually do is when we recover it, find a stuffy and mount it, you know, like either stitch it or something to the area. So Tater's gonna have an... Yeah. But it's something else. You know, maybe I'll put a piece of wood in there, a dowel, and then put a stuffed animal that can be sort of static in that position that they can spar with. Oh, yeah.
Ping pong ball would work.
She's got a couple that she plays with all the time. I'll have to snag one. She's just working on bark. They all do it. I have no idea what's in there. I'm sure that in the fiber of the wood and in what's growing on it, the algae and the lichen and things. Hey, Sharon. I'm sure there are many, many microscopic and minuscule things in there that I'm unaware of that are just part of what makes a squirrel a squirrel. I know they eat that stuff that grows on some of these oak trees, that green lichen looking thing. Sort of frilly. Clear of it. Nice flip over. From the bottom position. Rolls right into guard. In watching this, and the other day I was fooling around with slow-mo stuff, it's their back legs, where they're like kangaroos. Everything is all about kick. Even standing, she'll jump and try to slash out with her back claws. Nice entrance. Rolls right into the ring. Now goes for the big guy. Stick.
Oh, hi.
Yeah, sure do. Hope you weren't counting on that lifting you up. Go. She's just ready to fight with anybody. Source of the sound. As I'm moving this, it's brushing against the edge, and rather than go and fight with Batty, she wants to find out what's making that noise and
stop it.
Yes, it's Bun Bun. I'll tell you the truth. Bun Bun makes the noise. Oh, jeez, I didn't mean for you to get all... Thanos on me, gee. I was kidding, it wasn't Bun Bun. You didn't have to throw him off the cliff.
Yeah, who said she was still over there? Dad, no, Daddy doesn't wear shorts since we started doing squirrels. And for many other reasons, but no, I don't wear shorts. I would look like I was the test subject for every weed eater blade and string in the world. Yeah, pay no attention to the man in the string.
It was Bun Bun. See? Bun Bun is destined not to make it. You gonna go save him?
Yeah.
If she really wants to, she can drag him back up here. She's moved him from room to room several times.
But right now, she's more interested in
where my boots been today. They were outside for a while.
Had to fix the bear fence. There was no bear, but the damage that the bear did.
And the way the squirrels bounce off of it like it's a spring. And of course, shoddy and terrible as it looks, I had to fix some of the slats. I suppose we should go. We've been here for a million years, and I'm sure people are going still on that squirrel. Right? Come on, change here. Just in time for not to need it. Enjoy your Sunday. Thanks for hanging out so long.
Or watching any part of this. Appreciate it.
Bye, Mija.
She's busy chewing on my shoe. See ya. Thanks. Visit Brisby Tales. A lot more videos getting ready to drop in there.